good to see.
Right.
This debate, though, COVID-19 is not going to stop this from coming up every year.
Nope. We're going to spring forward this weekend. Yes, daylight saving time. Is it necessary, though? I should go back a year from now and see if we did this question.
What do you think?
I think we did, didn't we?
Of course we did.
Yes, every year.
Because it's fun to argue about. Riley.
I don't care. Either way, honestly, I know. I mean, it's going to be here, right? I mean, they always say every year the bill, they're trying to change it, and it has not changed. And how long? I don't care. I really don't. I mean,
okay,
it's going to happen.
Riley? I'm going to take a stand.
I'm going to go to bed tonight or Saturday night the same time
care.
I do. I'll wake up, and then, you know, that's it.
I tell you, it's exhausting changing clocks. Heather, your thoughts?
It's hard.
Riley taking a very surprising viewpoint that he doesn't care either way. It's fine. Whatever. Change the clock.
I mean, I like the longer days. Yeah, I like the sunshine.
What if this was the very last time you ever changed your clock?
Sure.
Ah, wouldn't that be freeing?
Your power's going to go out. You'll be fine. You can change your clock.
Heather,
again.
You and Riley have young kids. I feel like that's the group most affected by the time change.
For sure. It's a giant change. I mean, because Riley, you and I, we don't do wake up time. We do bedtime.
Right.
So this is super annoying.
I can't even remember what happened yesterday. I'm trying to think. I was like, what happened yesterday? Maybe I'm just sleep deprived no matter what. No, yeah. I mean, I think that's the thing, too. If you have kids, younger kids, too, it's a challenge for a little bit. But, you know, you do what you got to do.
Yeah. Here's the thing. Kids get over it. It's fine. Here's what I don't want. I don't want my kids standing out at the bus stop at 8:30 in the morning and it is pitch black. That's what would happen if you got rid of this. Mm-hmm. You would be so dark so late in the morning.
But one thing about it, too, I mean, like in the fall or, you know, well, late fall, whatever, it gets dark at what time?
In December, after school activities, things too.
I mean, I remember going home after school. I mean, this is, you know, pre-COVID clearly, but it was dark. And my mom's like, you're walking home, aren't you? And I was like, it's dark.
So we're a little unusual here in that we have such a wide variation in sunrise and sunset. Most of the country doesn't see the dramatic change that we do.
No, which is interesting because if you look at the 15 states that have really tried to keep this, you know, same time all the way around, it's more of the southern states. It's the warmer states. It's not a lot of these northern states that have this, so it wouldn't really affect them quite as much.
Yeah,
right.
Jason, take a stand.
Well, which side are you on?
I'm on the.
You want to keep changing?
Keep changing.
I'm sick and tired of changing. Sick and tired of it. It's the dumbest thing ever. It doesn't save energy. There's an increase in medical effects. You have heart attacks after the change.
The studies on the energy are a little.
I care so much for you parents and your woes. Oh, boo hoo! Your kid can't sleep. You know. Let's get rid of it.
Yeah, that's because you take a 3-hour nap in the afternoon.
I mean,
you go home and cash out. When you have kids that are the age of 3, when they don't want a nap or whatever.
I have teenagers. They sleep for 14, 15 hours anyway.
You're good. You're
exactly.
What?